going to cut some pads to sit the deck mould on.
John's going
to
cut them for me.
Welcome to the long-awaited deck flipping mould episode, everyone, and life on the hulls, or should I say back on the mould again. A long-awaited episode. There's been a lot of talk about the deck mould itself, and it has sat idle for 3.5 years beside the hull while I build that and put in all the structure of that hull. Now, the deck wheels on the actual mould itself are giant steel casters, and these won't require a lot of space, so I decided to make these pads out of some rather thick sleeper pine and make similar to a caster that you'd sit under a lounge suite to cradle these wheels and ultimately be able to level up the mould and get it square, as the mould is sitting on a patch of dirt rather than on a concrete slab as the hull is. So very important that I had something that I could, you know, position the wheels on and stop it rolling around. Now, this week's episode is going to have a lot of that, including flipping the deck mould over, which was a rather anxious affair, and you'll see why as the wind got up. So let's get into it, everyone.
Now, I've got a bit of a challenge. When we flip this over, we're not going to have any way of picking it up. So back here are the forward hatches on the front cabin, and these panels I put in to stop the water leaking through while I was working on the underside of the mould way back when, and they now have to be removed so that I can get some straps through that to be able to pick this mould up and roll it back into spot. When we flip this mould over, which is upright now, and we flip it over, I've got all this beautiful mould surface. The problem is I've got nothing then to hook up the crane to, and I don't want to go glassing anything in because that, you know, obviously it's on a mould surface, I don't want to grind it off and then go back and repair. So I'm going to remove these today, and that'll give me one chance to get straps through onto this steel beam here and on the back there, because it really only has to move 10 feet. It has to be lifted about an inch off the ground and move back. What I can't do is I can't wrap it around the whole mold, or it's going to collapse the side of the mold. The mold's so old that if I wrap a strap around and go up, there's a good chance it's going to go and wreck the side of my beautiful mold surface. So I don't want that to happen, so this is my best bet here, and I'm gonna have to find a place down the back to do the same. I just held on with a couple of batten screws. All I've got underneath here is a piece of 4x2 that goes underneath, and then it's batten screwed in. So hopefully when that comes loose, the Sikaflex will give. And then I should be able to just... So that piece of 4x2 has just collapsed in there. And then it should just be a matter then of lifting this off. Yep, there we go. So, and this is my hatch, my 45 centimeter hatch, 45 centimeter square hatch, and that down in there is my bed. Cool. And then same deal over here. This one here has to be gone as well. Perfect. All right, so I'm going to put a hole in the back of the hatch here, and the other one here, right where this hole saw mark is. This is actually the imprint or the molding for the rear hatch over the top of the stern cabin, and it means I can get a strap, the nylons from the crane, and bring them through here to the framework of the mold. And I know that the deck mold is actually stern heavy, so if we can get it further back here and pick it up here, that gives us a chance to move it forward and then use those front hatches as well. So I'm gonna cut that now. Bring out the big gun. The other one just couldn't cop it. Right. I've just come down to the mould here. I've got a few things I've got to do. I've got to work out how I'm going to actually pick the mould up once it's flipped over. I'm going to have to leave the flipping over in Derek's hands because, you know, it's just doing my head in how he's going to lift it over, and I'm hoping my support legs that I've put in are going to be substantial enough for him to rocker the thing over. Once it's upright, we're going to have to work out how to physically lift it. It's only got to lift 6 inches into the air so it can actually be driven forward, back the full width of the mould, back onto the site that it's sitting on now. Now, underneath here, you'll notice I've put a blue strap across here. What I've done is I've actually tied it into the steel structure around the outside, and I've got two of these straps. I may even put a third one in just in case the mould lets go from the steel frame. If that happens, I'm in a world of trouble. I'm going to be redesigning a whole new deck for my boat, and I do not want to do that. So the more preparation I can do right now, the better. So there's a strap under here. There's also another one running right across under here around the back of the door, the main door at the rear, and then up and to the steel framework. So very important that I put that one in. It's almost a little bit of assurance that it might catch the mould if it decides to physically fall off the steel frame. Unlikely, but who knows? Anything can happen when you're dealing with a thing of this size. Now the other thing too, when I moved the mould, I put in a whole lot of wooden frameworks along here, bolted them to the back of the deck, which actually kept the deck and the hull separate while it was being shipped. So I'm going to remove them now, just got to undo them. I've got a couple more to do, and then I'm going to get these pallets out of here, tidy up under here, and pretty much get ready for mould flipping day tomorrow. There is never a dull moment here on the hulls, boys and girls. That is getting flipped in the morning. They're coming in the morning, they're gonna flip this over. I'm so glad I didn't do it on the day I was gonna do it, back when I demolded the hull, because I simply wasn't ready. As much as you wanna be ready, I've had to do a heap of work on that, so that's gonna get flipped over. We've cleared the decks, we've cleared the entire parking lot, and Janet's here. We've gotta move this target mould. We've gotta get it up the back, out of the way, and that's pretty much all we can do, and that's all in the hands of our boys with the crane.
So the targa mould, which I don't think you guys have seen before, is actually a two-piece mould. This is half of it. It'll give you an idea of scale when you look at it in the picture here. It's quite a large unit, and it'll be made in two pieces and then glued together. Now, it's interesting when you're learning how to use a pallet jack. Janet and I have quite a few moments where I'm trying to show Janet how to steer it, and then I realise that I'm no better at steering it either. So we end up just skull-dragging the thing up to the back wall and pinning it against the fence here. There's always a couple of things to lift around here, and Janet just lends a hand, gets right into it. I love it. It's brilliant.
Every day on this project seems to be a milestone of late. I've got the crane coming in about 15 minutes. I'm intensely worried about it, even more so than the mould itself when I demoulded the hull. Reason being is we're not sure of the weighting of this. I do have photos from previous lifts when I lifted it off the hull and put it down here onto the ground. But when we lift it up, the last thing we want to do is actually shuffle towards our brand new hull and our tent. And we also have to pivot it over on those legs, down onto the wheels, and then ultimately over. And then I've got to work out how we're going to lift it. Now, I've been working on that over the last couple of days, but milestone days, haven't had much sleep, been a little bit worried about it. I get a little bit intense at night and couldn't wind down. I'm in trouble for keeping Janet awake all night because I was shuffling around and it was hot. So I had the air conditioning on to try to cool down. Yeah, days like these, they're defining moments, and you got to get on with it. It's about 6:30, crane's going to be here about 20 minutes, and hopefully by 8 o'clock, that's back in place on those mounts that I've made. So Janet will be here in about 10 minutes. She's working from home today. She'll be hopefully home by 8 a.m. to get started at work. Oh, the help's arrived. We haven't got a lot of help today. We didn't tell anybody. We're trying to keep it a little bit low-key, but Janet's here. She's here to oversee the operation. Everyone's still in bed, so. And we've cleared the decks. The mechanics moved everything out of here for us just to do this. This is what it's all about. Big, big, big day.
No, the camera's out again.
And as usual, the crane arrived on time, and Derek was sitting in there with a young
fella by the name of Nathan, and he was a top young bloke who was learning the job, obviously, and we needed to discuss the weighting of this mould. I had a few concerns about it being extra heavy towards the stern and around that cockpit area, so it was very important that we try to lift this very carefully so that it doesn't actually slide in sideways and spin around and go into our beautiful hull sitting underneath the tent.
Got to try and get this done before Neil starts his day's work with all the cars. But to stop them coming in, Ross is locking the gate.
So in rigging the crane to lift the deck mould up, I was able to reference those photographs I've had when I removed the deck off the hull. Made a big difference being able to reference back, and by doing that I was able to position these chains at the right position to make sure that it didn't swing. What I hadn't factored in was the wind. You can see it here in the bush here blowing around, and we did have quite a lot of wind. It was forecast to get to 30 knots that afternoon. What I wasn't anticipating was a couple of big gusts as we were turning the thing over. The stress was pretty high. It was amazing how much anxiety we had in this event. Janet and I were both pretty worked up. I think Derek was pretty calm, but it's nothing, you just couldn't believe the size of the thing when we lifted it up. It just seemed so much bigger than when we demolded the hull, and its windage really didn't help. But as you can see here, as I'm lifting it, it's pretty much level, and those legs that I'd welded onto the side, I was concerned that they may collapse and then do subsequent damage to the edge of the mould, but they didn't. They held true. One thing they did do though, they actually sunk into the ground, and that created a couple of problems. It did actually pivot on one of them rather than on all three at one stage here, so we had a lot going on. Now, in any other video, I'd probably time-lapse this or put some music over it, but for now, I'm just inviting you onto the site here, and, you know, although we closed the gate, it's open for all of you to watch, and I'm just going to let it run a little bit because you don't sort of get a feel for how much work's involved purely from the crane driver, from the dog man, and from myself and Janet. In an instance like this, when we time-lapse it, it's quite a laborious task moving things around and getting things ready. So I'm just going to let it go as if you're on site with us, and I hope you enjoy it. You'll see this whole thing appear in front of your eyes, and yeah, it's quite a massive undertaking in all. You can see here I've actually placed tyres under the pivot legs there just so I didn't damage the concrete. Now, this mould is 5.5 tonnes. It's actually as heavy as the hull mould, and a lot of that is the steel. But you can't believe the weight of the thing. But when we got it up on its edge, those tyres there just, as I said, they offered a bit of a cushion as I lifted it over. And as you can see, I was pretty worked up. Now, as we got it up on its side, things started to go a bit awry. We had a big gust of wind and blew it around, and I wasn't prepared for that. We had basically Nathan there dogmanning the thing into place. And it's amazing when you get something up like this how easily you can actually maneuver it. But the wind was having quite an effect. I was then able to get a couple of pallets and some tyres as well to position the wheels on as well to avoid damaging those wheels. It's all trusting in my welding at this point, and so far it's held true. Even though it's not great welding, it certainly got through the job.
Yeah, that's your idea. Let me try to catch you straight, man.
Looking at it at this position, it's just massive, this thing, and this view here really shows the size of it. And you know, that it's 25 feet wide and 41 feet long, so it's an absolutely massive piece of kit. And when it's suspended like this, yeah, very concerning to see it bobbling around in the wind. Now at about this stage I was starting to relax, given that we'd rolled it right over. My only concern here was the chain on the side of the mould, and we seemed to avoid that problem until right now. And the thing then took a mind of its own, decided to rip off the pallets, and we were able to control it just by pulling it in with the ropes. Once we got it over, it was simply a matter of lifting it up, but a couple of concerning moments there as well. Anxiety levels were quite high. Right, well that was pretty horrible, I've got to be honest. Let's have a look inside here. We're about to, what I've done is the hatch here, and the hatch here, we're gonna put a nylon down there under the steel bar below, one down there, and then also, let's have a walk on here and let's have a look. And then we're gonna have a nylon down through this hole, and down to the steel down there. I haven't left them much room, but I'm sort of hoping it's gonna be enough to hold it. It looks pretty strong, but yeah, this is the first time I've seen this up this way. To be my home for the next few months. You missed the best part, young Neil. Mate, it was sketchy. Man, it was scary shit. We're almost there, we reckon another half hour will be gone. Might need a trolley jack at some point. On our site, we've left him with this much room. He's got plenty of room, just didn't realize it was gonna end up this far over. First time I've seen it upright, or upside down in fact. Anyway, stage one done. Stage two, we've got to move it. Now on the day we demoulded the hull back in December, we were actually going to flip this deck mould over after we dealt with the mould and putting the hull back in under the tent. Pretty glad we didn't do that, because this took a lot more thinking than I anticipated. Firstly, making the pads to go under the wheels. Secondly, how I was going to lift this back into place
when it was upright like it is now, and you can see Nathan and I in here standing and adjusting the chain heights. But when you see the hook go up, you'll see that the nylons actually remain straight, and that's what I was aiming for, is an equal pressure on all of those nylons, so it wasn't going to cause any undue stress on the deck mould itself. Once Derek put some tension on it, we could see that it was going to lift without any damage, and then simply lifted it up in place, and we were able to roll it in and get it all level on those mounts. This part actually went quite smoothly. Greg from across the road woke up and decided to show up, and walked across the road and came in and gave us a hand to put it in. He helped me level it up as we got it back onto the site. So a very successful morning, albeit a bit stressful, but certainly very, very pleasing to have it done. And now I've got a few months of work ahead of me, getting the tent ready, getting some brackets done, and putting that second container shelter over the top so I can work in all weather. Now, I have chosen autumn for a very good reason. Here in Jervis Bay, we have very mild winds in autumn, and it'll actually be, this tent will be a little bit more exposed to the wind, so it's a very good time of year for me to do it. It is also a little bit cooler, and however, we've had quite a damp and wet summer, so it's going to be interesting how the next few months pan out, but there's plenty to come.
Brilliant. Nate, live on the holes, mate. Go and get some new shorts. Mate.
How did it go?
Look who shows up for work.
I'm not working today.
It's You're not working today. He's having the day off. Can you believe my right-hand man is having the day off?
I'm going to church.
You're on the church, mate. I've got polishing to do. That's the church.
Look at that.
Mate, dead level. Well, I think it's not quite dead level. Huge, isn't it? Come in. Come in, let's go have a look. So I've got all this place here to work under. I'm gonna set up a deck in here with some pallets so I can have my machine here so it's all clean. And then, yeah.
Well, at least you're not down in the hole. You can walk on this.
Oh yeah, yeah, it's still, there's a few repairs to do.
No, but you're not in a big gully. You're not climbing out of holes.
No, it's
still pretty good, Nick, isn't it?
Yeah, no, this surface is all right. There's a lot of work to be done here, but the surface prep is fine. Come up here. I've got a problem up here. Walk up the ladder, John, though.
There's no problem,
mate. Terry Burns, our truck driver, told me he broke it, and I've got a little bit of damage here, so I'm going to have to repair this bit and repair the nose cone.
What happened there?
Oh, I think when he moved it, it sort of shifted, like the weight was a bit wrong, and it's
bent there too.
And it's bent up here. So yeah, no, pretty good, eh?
Wow.
Yep. Be a lot of time spent in here now. Have a look up the back here.
That's great.
Watch you don't fall off here, mate.
That's easy to get to then.
Fucking high, isn't it?
Everything's easy to get to.
Watch you don't fall. But see these legs? This is gonna hold the tent.
Brilliant.
See right up here. Watch that, that's a bolt there. What do you reckon? What do you reckon, son?
Looks good, doesn't it?
Life on the hulls. Life on the deck. Life on deck. Yeah. Oh, yeah. I've got a lot of repairs to do. And you know, the worst thing is, look at this. The bloody cut is just on the other side of that freaking zipper line.
Whoa.
So I'm going to have to tidy it up here.
Make a bigger line.
I'll make the line wider.
Well, that.
I can do that. We can do it, John.
Wow.
Awesome, eh? Well, I'm sorry you missed it, but I'll tell you what, you've saved yourself a heart attack.
That's a good nick, isn't it?
Yeah, it's good. Whoa! What did you think of that, Janet? Just called you Ellen.
Yeah, I know.
What did you think of all that? Stressful?
Yeah, a bit. My stomach was really...
Come in. Come into our deck.
Huh?
There she is. We don't do anything in halves, do we, honey? Jesus.